A truly compassionate political leadership should be asking whether our poor and needy are getting sufficient help. A nationwide study conducted last year by the research team from Lee Kuan Yew School of Public Policy found about 1,000 people sleeping rough in the streets of Singapore. I want to dedicate my candidacy to people who have been dealt a bad hand in life, who find themselves in vulnerable and precarious situations. We need leaders with compassion, humility, and a conscience to help the most vulnerable Singaporeans without making judgments about the needy and poor.
I learned a lot from my first term in Parliament, and there are many areas I intend to build upon if voters give me a chance to do so. I will tap more on subject matter experts, and I will put my ear closer to the ground. Being an elected MP with constituents to consult will certainly help. I'm prepared to reach across the aisle to come up with the best solutions to solve the challenges we face as a nation. That's what constructive politics should be about, being laser focused on achieving results for the benefit of Singaporeans.
Do we want a country dominated by the views of a few, or one where healthy and vibrant views can be exchanged respectfully without accusations of disloyalty? Do we want a country where we sweep the vulnerable under the carpet, or one where they can actually live dignified lives? Do we want a country which pursues economic goals at the expense of all other considerations, or one where we aim for sustainable growth for all? For me, the answer is clear. My children will, in time, like their father, enlist to defend their country and pledge to serve it. I want them to be proud of their country that has overcome obstacles by bringing its most vulnerable along with it, a country where they can have strong and respectful disagreements with one another, and a society which pursues growth but cares about the impact our actions have on our people and planet.
Why am I running again? To contribute to balance in politics, to emphasize that balance is not the enemy of unity, and that our unity as a nation, our being one united people, cannot be based on our just following one political party, our just having one political affiliation. And in fact, our unity as a country should be unity across different political affiliations. That was the theme of the first speech I made in Parliament in January 2016. Unity should not be defined by political allegiance. Disagreement does not mean disrespect. Debate does not mean division. The extreme dominance of one party, one group of people over the whole society is not a good thing for Singapore in the long term.